Hello everyone, iCool Tech here. Today we're going to be taking a look to see how the iOS 15.1 public release runs on the iPhone SE first generation. Now you have iPhone SE, you care about iPhone SE, and I cover iPhone SE, so you would benefit greatly from tapping or clicking that subscribe button and enabling post notifications using the bell icon below. Alright, so kicking things off with overall performance. Now, since updating from iOS 15.0, 0.0.1, and 0.0.2, I have noticed a slight performance boost overall with iOS 15.1. Now, this is a really normal occurrence for updates like this after a major release, so it's not very surprising. I will say on top of that that the performance increase isn't anything massive or game-changing, but it is there and always welcome. Now, of course, animations remain pretty much the same. I haven't noticed any difference in overall speed. Everything is still really fast and fluid on the iPhone SE on iOS 15.1. Now, same thing goes with RAM management. Again, no difference. I wouldn't say that it's any worse. It's maybe slightly better, but to the point where I would just label it as no change. Alright, so before we talk about battery life for the iPhone SE on iOS 15.1, for integrity reasons, I should really let you all know that my maximum battery capacity is currently 87%. Now, this iPhone has experienced an unexpected shutdown, but as you can see here, I have disabled all the protections. Alright, so battery life on the iPhone SE, it's been improved over iOS 15.0. Nothing major, it's not going to make you compare your friend's flagship iPhone battery life to your iPhone SE first gen, saying, you know, oh, my battery life is just as good as yours now. Yeah, that's never gonna happen. But I will say it has been improved, and I'm sure that it will be welcome to many of you. However, I will say it's still bad. It's never gonna be fixed. But I will say it will be improved, and then it will have problems, and then it'll be improved again, and then it'll have problems for a while, and it'll just get worse, and all of a sudden it'll be improved, and then just sad. But anyway, so the iPhone SE has, yeah, it's been improved. Noticeable battery drain with standby time. Just kidding, actually. It's been really, really, really awesome. The battery drain during standby time is around 10 to 12% per night in my tests. Now, that sounds like a lot, not at all. And overheating, non-existent still. Nothing's changed. iOS 15.0 has been really good. iOS 15.0.1, 0.0.2, and 15.1. I haven't had any problems with overheating just yet. I also have to warn you guys that after updating iOS, you will very likely notice the opposite of everything I just said, overheating and battery drain during standby or use. Now, the reason for this is easy. It's just because the device has to undergo a process which is called indexing. Now, what this does is it's basically the device running a ton of background processes. We're not going to go into detail, but just runs a ton of background processes that do use up a lot of battery and will cause the phone overheat. This should last at most 3 days. If you continue having the problem after 3 days, you could always try a restore, but that most likely means you're one of those very unlucky few who just are gonna have problems. All right, now that all of that has been taken care of, should you update? Okay, so I do this in a way that's not me telling you that if I say you're gonna update, you're going to update right now and you have no other choice. No. When I say if you should update or if you shouldn't, it's a recommendation. If you are on iOS 15.0, 15.0.1, or 15.0.2, I would recommend updating. If you're still on iOS 14.8 or earlier, there's very likely a reason you're currently on that release. If you're on iOS 14.8 or earlier, and you aren't updating because you're afraid of any problems with iOS 15, I would recommend waiting a little bit longer for maybe iOS 15.1.1, 15.1.2, 15.2 even, just for the extra fixes. Alright everyone, that is all I have for this video, and if you do have any questions or you'd just like to say hi, make sure to leave a comment down below. Of course, definitely make sure you follow me on Twitter using the link in the description below. I don't know why I tap my desk because is there a link down? Hold on, guys, I think there's a link for my Twitter page down here. Hold up. Oh yeah. Oh, that's beautiful. Anyway, so yeah, make sure to do that. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next one.